हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल डू यूजेज ऑफ डायमेंशनल इक्वेशंस। देन यस्टरडे वी हैव डन अबाउट द डायमेंशन इक्वेशन, दैट देयर वी हैव डन फिजिकल, दैट चैप्टर स्टार्टेड फिजिकल वर्ल्ड मेजरमेंट। देयर वी हैव डन डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस। इन दिस डायमेंशन वी हैव डन अबाउट दिस डायमेंशनल फॉर्मूला, that is in form of the MLT. There M is stand for mass, L for the length, and T stand for the time, and A, B, C are the dimension of the dimension formula of the physical quantity. Then for example, there is example given that volume about the force, density, area, there find out the dimension equation. Now what are the use of these dimension equation? Now today we will do uses. Now there is a three use of this dimension equations. Correction of one system of unit into the another. How we can converge one system of unit? That is the if our units are given in CGS unit, then how we can convert into MKS unit? If MKS unit, then how we can convert into CGS unit? Then there is a first use, conversion of one system of unit into another system. Second use of the dimension equation, checking correctness of the formula. How there is the formula is correct or wrong, that correctness of any formula we will check by using the dimension equation. That if any formula is given that this dimension is right or wrong, then this one is our correction we will check by using this dimension equation. Now third use, derivation of formula. For making the derivation of any formula, any relation is given, then how we can form a formula of that physical quantity, then we will form by using the dimension equation. There is a different use, how we can perform their uses, now we will do. Now first we will do conversion. Of one system of unit into another system. First we will do this one. Let we are taking there one system, we are taking there U1, and another system we are taking U2. Now there is a term is given, unit of this one is N1 we are taking, and N2 is for this one we are taking. Now how we can find that unit of measurement U1 and U2 of two system? Let units of measurement of two system U1 and U2 are U1 we can write there M1A L1 raised to power B T1 raised to power C. This one is the first dimensional relation. For U2 we are taking M2 L2 and there is a T2, and here power we are taking ABC. Now here we have taken this one M1 U1, and there is a, now after this one how we can find this term? Let we are finding their unit of this one second term, then how we can find their N2 equal to N1 U1 by U2. Now put value of this term, then we can write there N1 M1 L1 T1 divide by M2 L2B and T2C. Now separate this term, then we can find it. How we can separate there this term? This one term, how we can separate? Then we will take their divide separately in the different term. लाइक दिस वन एन वन एम वन बाई एम टू बिकॉज देर इज अ पावर इज सेम देन वी कैन राइट लाइक दिस वन एल वन एल टू बी एन टी वन टी टू सी नाउ दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर एन टू लाइक दिस वी कैन फाइंड इट क्लियर टू एवरी वन नाउ फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी कैन फाइंड देयर वन न्यूटन इक्वल टू हाउ मेनी डाइम दिस वी आर फाइंडिंग दैट वन न्यूटन इक्वल टू हाउ मेनी डाइम दिस रिलेशन हाउ वी कैन फाइंड बाय यूजिंग दिस मेथड हाउ वी कैन यूज दिस मेथड नाउ देयर वी आर कन्वर्टिंग देयर दिस वन गिवन इन एमकेएस यूनिट एंड दिस वन इज द सीजीएस यूनिट व्हेन वी आर कन्वर्टिंग देयर एमकेएस यूनिट वी आर कन्वर्टिंग इन टू सीजीएस यूनिट देन इन एमकेसीएस यूनिट दिस वन इज द यूनिट ऑफ फोर्स दैट इज द यूनिट ऑफ फोर्स सो दैट्स वाई दैट इज द एमकेएस यूनिट ऑफ फोर्स सो दैट्स वाई वी कैन राइट देयर वी हैव डन डायमेंशनल फॉर्मूला अबाउट द फोर्स दैट एम वन एल वन टी माइनस टू दिस रिलेशन ऑलरेडी वी हैव डन देन हाउ वी कैन कन्वर्ट दिस इन टू डाइन then first we will find there for the we have convert this into cgs unit so m1 equal to 1 kg here m1 l1 t1 and m2 m2 n2 we are finding here m1 l1 our 1 meter t our 1 second t1 our 1 second and same m2 hour 1 gram l2 hour 1 centimeter and t2 hour 1 second that is time will remain same in cgs mks unit m1 will be 1 kg l1 will be 1 meter and m2 will be 1 gram and L2 will be 1 centimeter. Now put there this in this relation then we can write there N2 equal to N1 there M1 by M2 A L1 by L2 B T1 by T2 C. Now here how we can find there N1 as we know that there is a 1 Newton. N1 is 1. This one is our N1. Now here write N1. Then there 1 kg by 1 gram. 1 A is 1. B 1. C minus 2. Here we can write there A equal to 1. B equal to 1. And C equal to minus 2. Now put value of 4 relation. Then L1 equal to 1 meter. By 1 centimeter 1 and there 1 second here 1 second minus 2 now this cancel out with this one here left this one 1 gram is equal to how many kilogram is equal to 1 gram there is a 1000 gram equal to 1 kg now this one we can write there and there is a 10 1 centimeter there centimeter 1 centimeter centimeter this cancel out here will come 10 raised to power 5 clear then n2 equal to 10 raised to power 5 so from here we can write there 1 newton equal to 10 raised to power 5 dyne this we have done clear use of this how we can use this one This is the first use of the dimension equation. Now we will use their second use of this one dimension equation. How we can write there? What is the second use of this equation? Second use is the चेकिंग द करेक्टनेस ऑफ द फॉर्मूला, चेकिंग करेक्टनेस ऑफ फॉर्मूला, हाउ वी कैन करेक्ट इट, दिस वन रिलेशन देयर इज अ चेकिंग हाउ वी कैन राइट देयर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी आर टेकिंग दिस रिलेशन टी, टी इक्वल टू 2π अंडर रूट एल बाई जी, वेयर टी इज टाइम पीरियड ऑफ पेंडुलम एंड एल इज लेंथ एंड जी इज एक्सीलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. Now there we will do that how we can find this one, this relation is right or wrong. This one term is used for checking the correctness of formula, that this formula we have written t equal to 2π under root l by g, where if we are taking a pendulum and this pendulum is get oscillating, then their time period taken by one complete oscillation is t, l will be length of the pendulum and g is the acceleration due ग्रेविटी. नाउ दिस फॉर्मूला वी विल चेक बाई यूजिंग द डायमेंशन इक्वेशन, दिस फॉर्मूला इज राइट और रोंग. नाउ हाउ वी कैन चेक इट, फर्स्ट वी विल राइट द डायमेंशनल इक्वेशन. नाउ चेकिंग द करेक्टनेस, फर्स्ट राइट डायमेंशन equation of whole term. First we will write dimension equation of whole term. Yes, everyone can write this dimension equation of whole term or physical quantity. Then t, first we are writing for t is time period. For time period there is a absence of m, absence of l, then only t. So that's why we will write only t. Now for the l, l is equal to length. For the length how we can write there, m 0, l 1 and t equal to 0. M raised to power 0 means 1, l raised to power means l, because there is a length, there is only presence of length, mass absence, and there is a absence of time. That's why the dimensional formula of length will be this one. Next our g. G is our acceleration due to gravity. I think everyone know about the acceleration due to gravity, that is the acceleration due to the effect of the earth. Any object is accelerating in up and down, that will be acceleration due to gravity. That is value is 9.8. And this one is the acceleration. So acceleration you have done already. That is the velocity per unit time is known as the acceleration, and velocity will be length per unit time. So dimensional formula will be m raised to power 0, l raised to power 1 and t raised to power minus 2. This one is the dimensional formula will remain same as the acceleration, this one. There of all a dimensional formula we have written, then we will write in this relation, their relation is given, then in this relation we will write left hand side our, that is t, this is equal to our t, and right hand side our given 2π under root l by g. Now this relation we can write there under root their l and divide by l t minus 2. Here we can write there this relation, this cancel out with this one. Now here left only under root 1 by t minus 2. Now here we can write that t square and here will be under root. Now this to this cancel out, here will be left only t. Clear now everyone? Now check there. Hence left hand side equal to right hand side. So dimensionally this relation is correct. Clear to everyone? This one is the correctness of the formula that t equal to 2 pi under root l upon g. Then there we can check it by using the dimension equation. How we can write? First we will write the dimension formula of all term. Then we will check their left hand side equal to right hand side dimensionally. If both are equal, then we can say that that relation is correct. Otherwise it will be wrong relation. So next part we will do tomorrow. Third part. For your homework, try to do question, solve up to this part. Then for homework, then one question I am giving to you. Check s equal to ut plus half at square. This you have to check where s distance, u velocity, a is acceleration and t is time. Try to solve this one. Check their correctness of this question. Next part we will do tomorrow. Okay, thank you.